And now continuing on with the Brits Off Broadway Festival here at 59 East 59th Street. I didn't tell you where it was, but that's a very easy address to remember. That's also the address of the theater, is the name of the theater, between Madison and Park. We're sitting here with two more members of the wonderful play, Memory. We have Christian McKay and to coax me through this,
Ifan Huw Dafydd.
Ifan Huw Dafydd.
That's brilliant. That's
okay.
Very good.
As I said, one of my dearest, closest friends was Welsh too, so she was always trying to get me to pronounce things correctly to no avail. Anyway, you're in Memory and you're also making a documentary on me, or what's going on here?
What are you doing?
Well,
I'm just making a fly on the wall documentary of Memory's trip over to New York. A little bit of us at the beginning of the DVD will be of the history of Theatre Clwyd for the last 10 years since Terry Hands took over, and then sort of see how well Memory has travelled in New York here.
And Memory, of course, is the name of the play. He's not just flashing back here. That's the name of the play. We have to keep saying the name of the play. And this is Christian McKay, who's in Memory, but you're also Orson Welles. You look just like him, I hate to say.
We both that. Like pies.
Yeah. Right. Me too. Well, that makes three of us. Okay.
You could play him too.
Right. And you're doing a one-man show?
That's right. When I finish Memory.
Unbelievable.
I'm doing my show, Rosebud, The Lives of Orson Welles, in this theater, in Theater C here.
And as time rolls on, what are the dates that you'll be playing here? Because if you can't rush out and see Memory this weekend, you'll still be here doing...
That's right, doing Rosebud. We finish Memory May 27th, and I start on May 29th.
Oh, brother! So that's quick!
I lose all my friends and I get a cigar for company.
Well, we're in Theater C. There's three theaters here, and that's where you'll be doing.
It's the first time I've been in here, actually, today. So this is the...
Claustrophobic, isn't it? It's small! It's really small. It's made specifically for doing one-person shows. And Ifan, can you tell us, or do you want somebody else to be shooting this at the same time, right?
Yeah.
Well, do we have any volunteers from the audience?
You're
here.
I just happened to be here.
Look at this beautiful young...
I've got big hair and I can film.
Thanks, Ifan.
That's all right. Carry on.
Okay, thank you, whoever you were.
Time.
Right. Sir, tell us about the history of this wonderful theater, because you've been involved with it for, what did you say, 10 years? That's wonderful.
Well, Viv, I, myself, Ollie,
yeah.
Who else from the cast?
Simon Neill.
Simon Neill.
No, not Simon.
Simon wasn't there right at the beginning. But so 10 years ago, Terry Hands took over Theatre Clwyd.
Because he did.
Theatre Clwyd was practically on its knees and on the way out. And Terry Hands...
I hear Wales is not the most prosperous region of England. I mean, it's difficult for a theatre to survive anywhere.
Yeah.
But this is in a small town called Mold.
That's
and
right.
I'm just thinking it was a Cardiff or something, but no.
No, it's a small town right out in the sticks, and it's a marvelous theatre that they built there back in the 70s.
Oh.
And it had a troubled past, and Terry Hands took over. And he created, from that first year, and he's built on it since, a Welsh company of actors.
Oh, that's wonderful.
And we've been all very proud to work for him and to work at Theatre Clwyd. And,
Terry Hands from the Royal Shakespeare Company, and my hat is color coordinated. Anyway, the Royal Shakespeare Company, I saw one of the first things he did, and this is true, I would have told him this, but since you're here, I'll tell you. When I was in school in England, he directed, they were doing the problem plays at Stratford. Mm-hmm. And he was like the new kid they just hired, and they were all like from Oxford or where, Cambridge or wherever he came from. And he was directing Pericles there with Ian Richards. And I saw that, and I remember it vividly to this day. And everyone was like, oh my God, is he going to do, how is he going to, and he's done very well, thank you. Flash forward to 2007, he's fine. And now he has this wonderful theater.
That's right. Yeah, and I think I can safely say that since he's got to Theatre Clwyd, he's turned the place around. And
I think that
I'd be fair to say that on behalf of all the actors that work there, that but whatever production we happen to be in with him, we're very proud to be in that production because, unfailingly, it's good. It's a good quality production.
And have you been to New York before, sir?
No, never. Only in my dreams.
Oh, And you, Christian, is this your first time?
That's my second visit.
Your second visit.
Yeah.
You've been in another show here, or?
No, but I have visited here before.
Right, and you have a special relationship, I think, with your sound crew and lighter. It's your wife, isn't it?
Oh, yeah. Oh,
she'll be happy you forgot her.
Cut that.
The biggest laugh of the day. Okay.
Let's what's go to a commercial break.
Right, we don't have commercials. We don't report.
On my show, yes. Right. Yes, indeed. Yeah.
What is her name? Now we've got to say it, right?
My wife is an actress. She's Emily Allen.
Okay.
As my producer, company manager, you know, PR, everything, she's Emily McKay. Recently, okay. We got married in December in Australia.
Oh,
yes.
Congratulations. Is she Australian?
She's Australian,
oh.
Yes.
Well, I think she's absorbed a perfect British accent because I couldn't tell when I met her.
Yeah, oh, right.
She's Australian.
Yes, she's from
And
Adelaide.
Now I should say just quickly what you're playing in memory as we stroll down memory lane here and get all sidetracked. You're playing the director of the
I'm
play.
I'm playing the director, yes.
Who constantly interrupts with wonderful music.
Yes, that's right. I play the show's soundtrack, the Bach Goldberg variations during the show.
And it's a marvelous a theatrical device, yes. And your character is in Palestine.
That's right.
Strangely enough, it goes there too.
Yeah, I play an elderly Palestinian gent whose house is just about to be demolished to make room for the wall. So there's two walls in this production.
Well, I think it's wonderful that theater... Now I'm going to forget. Theater...
Cloyd.
Theater Kim... in Wales.
Go on.
All right. It's here at the Brits Off Broadway Festival, 59 East 59th Street. It's so brilliant. It's such a difficult play. You pull all of these different strands together, the rehearsal of the play within a play, the Palestinian play, and the Holocaust play, all combined. You got to stay on your... toes, pay attention to this one, but it's really worth it. It's very rewarding and it's absolutely brilliant. One of the best shows in New York. And I hope you get a chance to rush out and see it this weekend at 59 East 59th Street, Brits Off Broadway. Thank you so much.
Thank you.